David Faustino.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who Dark Journey.
This is Dr. Steve-o.
Everybody, this is the Cavernator.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, J-Rock.
Good evening, folks. This is James Duval.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
This is Kim Possible.
I'm Chris Holden-Reed.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi.
This is the evil Dr. Bad Vibes.
Again, this is Messy Bear.
And this is Mort from X-Men.
Hey, this is Andrew Gazzess.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
It's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rock.
And I'm Neil Young.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Ralph Garman here. You're listening to Droids Canada. You've made an excellent choice. You have chosen wisely.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
That means there's a lot of fucking swearing.
Hello.
Was a silky smooth transition. If you don't like it, fuck you all.
I really enjoyed it.
Fuck y'all. There you go. Look at it. You're feeling it.
I know, man. This is some non-copyrighted rip beat. So what's going on?
Not much.
Not much?
Yeah.
What do you mean, not much?
Well, we're back in the studio.
Oh, I didn't do it. I'm sorry.
Yes. Where's the studio?
In my apartment.
Maybe that's going to be something new for 2019. No, it's not.
What, that we're actually going to start reading the card again?
Yeah, are we going to read the card?
I don't know. We haven't read the card so long.
What is the card?
The card.
So, see, I've never kind of understood we would start a show. We would start a show always. We would talk about where you could listen to us. Like, all the different platforms that we're on. Like, this is the Droids Canada podcast. You can find us on Twitter and on SoundCloud and blah 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 and on Facebook and this and that.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing that I was always thinking is, if you're listening to it, you've actually already found it.
That's very true, yeah.
So is there a reason to say where you can find it?
Unless
people want to maybe find another platform?
Maybe they want to find another platform, Dan. Why are you going to be that fucking guy all of a sudden?
Well, no, because I've...
You're being that guy, Dan.
This 2019 is your thinking for me.
Well, I don't think somebody who's already listening to it would want to listen to it on a different platform.
Well, there's only one way to find out, so we're just going to play a quick thing, because you need to understand, and Dan brought it up.
Hello.
Yep. Be right back.
Thanks, guys. You can find their award-nominated podcast that is recorded in Todd's studio, in his apartment, on the following... The Tangentbound Network, Spotify, Laughable Podcast Network, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher Radio, Electronic Media Collective, Podbean, and the Points of Interest Network. And, of course, you can find us on our social media, on the Facebooks, at Droids Canada. You can find us on the Twitter, at Droids Canada, on Instagram, at the_droids_Canada, and the final place for all your geek needs at droidscanada.com. That's it for me. Back to you guys. Thanks, guys.
I am, like, totally dropping the ball on everything today, and it's your fault.
But you are Captain Transition.
I am.
I do have a very big question.
What's that?
What's that?
Music from the card. Is it from anywhere else than It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia?
No. It's always in Sunny Philadelphia.
Okay.
Always sunny in Philadelphia.
It's always.
I just wasn't sure if it was just from that or from somewhere else.
Matt.
That's a good pickup, though.
Hmm. Anyways, I don't even know what this podcast... Did we have a topic, really?
Not that I know of. I showed up to do a little podcasting.
I'm the new person here, and I
she
have
is.
A possible topic What's question.
This is a very deep topic.
No, but
it
first,
is.
First
it cuts right to the bone.
Cuts like a knife?
Not the bone, no.
So before we get into this, we
Dan's
need to
a
do
parent,
a,
but he hasn't had to deal with this.
We need to do a proper introduction to the newbie.
Please introduce me, Dan and or Todd.
Now, so... Whoa. Hello. So, now here's the first thing. When you're on the microphone, see, the beautiful thing about doing a podcast is, like I was saying earlier, you can flip a switch and be, you know, a character. You can be someone who you want to be. Now,
no one likes a fake person.
Do you want to be...
I swear I'm not fake.
No, they're really not.
We have created a robot.
A bionic... Mountain Man.
So, I am a sex doll that has come to life.
Oh, Jesus
well,
Christ.
Well, hello.
Talk to me, Goose. Pull up, Dan. Pull up.
So how about you introduce yourself to the Droids Canada family?
My name is Ellie. I am friends with Todd.
Friends.
Yes, friends.
Friends.
Quite close friends.
Friends.
I'm friends. New to the Welland
See what I'm
area.
Doing? See what I'm doing? Friends. Friends.
Yeah, he's being weird. And
I'm a little uncomfortable right now.
Is Why? Is it because I kept saying friends making eye contact with you?
Yes.
I swear I'm not trying to replace you, Dan. Oh.
No, there's then,
Yeah, she's encroaching.
I cannot be replaced. One of a kind.
Very true. Yeah, new to Welland. Very excited to be on Droids Canada podcast.
Look at this. We have excitement in the podcast studio.
Extreme excitement.
Excitement.
It feels like you're being like all shifty and stuff right now. You know that?
Me?
Yeah.
How so?
It just feels like it.
Feels like it. Well,
see, I feel plotting. I feel plotting.
I feel plotting. I do feel plotting.
Transition, man. Captain Transition.
No plots being had here.
Guys, what's on your mind tonight?
Hold on, I'll tell you in a second.
Woo! Oh, Ric Flair?
Why isn't H on anyone's mind?
And then back into the hip-hop beats. Look at this.
I'm a little rusty, man. We haven't recorded this in a while. So, should we just cut to it?
Sure.
Okay.
My possible
It's
topic.
Funny how uncomfortable he is. He's like on the edge of his seat right now. He's like, what's happening? Is this
Yes.
Dan?
Yes.
Dan, I'm pregnant.
Congratulations.
She doesn't know.
Oh, shit.
Oops. This is what Dan does when he's trying to tell us things not on mic.
She'll never understand.
Well, see, it works.
Jen, if you're listening to this podcast, you need to stop right now.
No, that's going to be a later episode, the Jen Don't Listen to This Show podcast.
Okay, so, what was it? I don't know.
Yeah, no, you two seem to be plotting.
Yes. Oh, what? Plot.
And you have a possible topic.
Okay,
she
so
does. I'm just kind of like here on
Ellie autopilot.
I have no idea if this topic would be fun for you guys.
Okay.
Snip, snip.
But it involves circumcision.
Oh, fuck yeah. All right.
Where this shit's going to get deep.
So, like, is it like circumcision as in, like, is it a mushroom or is it like a hooded rider? Like, that kind of?
That kind of circumcision.
Oh, I don't know. Do you want to have an anteater's snout between your legs?
No. It's...
Armadillo?
Do you find that that is something that you think is barbaric? Or is it something that is leading to better penis health?
Exactly. Good question.
Better
no, I just
penis
watched...
health. No one likes dick cheese.
That is true. No, there's a documentary out right now called American Circumcision, and it's quite interesting. But I have a brand new nephew. He's about a week old.
Yes.
And the question is in the air whether he should be circumcised or not.
So, myself, being a... I'm not an expert on it, but... That's kind of like, do you vaccinate your child or not?
Oh, Jesus.
No, it is. Because, well, they might not get the measles.
So
why subject themselves to those chemicals in them? But then again, they might get the measles. So you could not circumcise a kid.
And there was a recent measles concern a couple weeks ago.
That's why I said measles.
And we were at Niagara-on-the-Lake, by the way.
So you could... not circumcise a child, and then what if they have an infection problem when they're older and have to get it done when they're older, which may be
possibly the most painful experience that a guy can go through.
That's not true. Never had the herp yet.
What's that?
What?
So, but,
no, the queen of the hoppies.
They're harpies?
The hoppies.
Well, so what this documentary said was basically a lot of the studies that have been done are not the best outcome. Like, they're using false statistics.
Not proper sample size.
Not so much sample size, but just the way they calculate the data in the end. But a lot of the reasons why people push circumcision is things like sexual health against STDs and things like that. And apparently that's not...
Not
circumcision
true.
Or not doesn't actually really fight against it.
So,
good way to hide a herpes,
non-circumcised,
though.
Are you saying, would be like flavor pockets for STDs?
Flavor pockets! I sealed in the flavor!
Well, it's like, you know, is it...
Tastes like dick cheese.
You know, is it like, you know, is it... Well, I don't know, like... You know, can hold some of that goodness in?
And maybe like,
no,
oh, I'm
not.
So hungry.
That's,
I'm gonna...
that's what people think, but apparently that's not the case at all.
So it's bullshit. So that's
really...
the other side of the coin of it would be for, you know, aesthetically pleasing.
And that's the main reason it seems that people do it now. In America and Canada in that regard.
You did that wrong. It's America.
Right, America.
Yeah.
Is the only country that does circumcision on such a wide scale now.
The only country, Canada, like North America, you'd mean? Like,
yeah,
Canada, the United States, that
gets
rid of the Kentucky Fried Chicken skin.
Exactly. So, over in Europe and Africa and China, it's not really done, but here it is.
So, they are all hooded riders, and we are all...
Mushrooms.
Mushrooms. We're all, like, what's that, Super Mario. Do, do, do,
do, do, do. Toad.
Whoop. Mushroom head.
Toad.
Slap.
Are you talking
That's
about giving someone
Trump
a mushroom slap?
Like.
No, mushroom tattoo, isn't that it? Back to the Urban Dictionary you go. Mushroom slap. Look at it. Look at that. So, you know, Ellie, what would you say is, do you think a man should get snipped or not?
I kind of agree with the documentary in the end that it should be an adult consenting choice. But it's really painful when you're older, so why would you do it?
Exactly.
So really what it comes down to is aesthetics, and if that's the only reason you're doing it, then to do that on a baby
is... it preventative maintenance? Preventative maintenance.
Maintenance. That's a good way to put it. No, cutting off some skin is maintenance.
Dead serious.
Exactly. It's
I
pretty...
know someone whom... not me, whom had to have it done when he was in his later years, after teen years, and said the most painful thing humanly possible. Like,
I saw an episode of ER when someone tried doing it recently. Pass.
Would rather pass stones, but had to have it done because of that. If it would have been done when he was a child, he would not have had the infection that he had and would not have had to go through that. So it's a...
Yeah,
do
but then you,
you
get into, and I have known a couple of my friends with children who have needed to have it done in later years because of growth spurts and different reasons, and it was extremely painful. But should it be done for everybody because of a small percentage of people needing to do it later?
That's one of those questions I can't get answered because I can't, like, you can't ask a baby, hey...
What do you want?
Hey there,
will you be blowing air inside you?
Hey,
no,
there,
that reminds
Johnny.
Me.
Welcome to our family. Do you want us to sniff a little bit of your skin?
Well, like, we look at it first.
It's not as the old days where they...
Like.
Remember, what was it? Was it... it was a Mel Brooks film. Where he was a rabbi and he was... Oh, it was Robin Hood Men in Tights. And he had the little guillotine to do circumcisions.
There was also...
I'm the best kind out there. I don't even get the tip.
History of the World Part 1 as well. There was another where they wanted to see if a guy was a slave or not. You must give him some time. He has just been snipped. No, that was actually eunuchs. That was snipping the whole...
Wow.
The whole twig and berries off.
I don't know. Like, I mean...
Grey worm.
I'm not a prude. I've seen some porn in my time. I know.
What?
I know. It's just the whole anteater thing does nothing for me. It's like, or like an elephant trunk. It's like it's looking for a fucking peanut. Instead, it impregnated somebody. Backfired. I don't know. What the fuck? Like, that shit's weird,
does
man.
Does somebody want a peanut?
It's It's like there's actually women out there with ugly vaginas too.
There are.
Like,
And so then should those women get circumcised?
No. What?
Can
the vagina get circumcised? What?
Well, it's
like flap reduction?
Absolutely.
Well, I don't know how to say it.
It's funny. There's isn't that the number one reason for the bad Neil top 10?
Respect the hood, the vagina.
No, I don't know if that's the vaginal rejuvenation, but there's definitely got to be cosmetic surgery.
Well, I mean, Shatner's got enough of those done on his face. I'm sure they figured it out by now.
Myself, I have never had a vagina, so I'm not an expert on vagina. So, yeah, I don't know.
That's funny. I don't even know where to go here from here.
I think that there's surgery for just about everything. Would you guys not have something on you that you'd want different with surgery?
No.
Okay, let's
nothing?
See.
Not a nose job or a
look at this
facelift.
This is the best thing going on this body right now is this face.
The toe beside your big toe be shortened so that they're all even.
No,
what? No.
No, I like the bigger toe.
You don't fuck with the toes.
The bigger second toe. It's
no,
like a talon.
Then you'll next need to be chopping your toes off and then you'll have no feet.
Now,
no,
me being the guy on the show with the big nose.
You don't have a big nose.
I do.
No.
100% I do.
My brother's ex-wife had a big nose. We used to call her the nose. Sorry, Mike.
I do have a larger size nose. It's not a big nose.
It's not the Triple H nose.
Would I ever do anything to it? No, it brings me my power.
The power of what?
The power of nose.
I think it fits your face. Like, it's nice there.
Well, thank you. Now, yeah, I don't know. Is there something on me that I would
change? I don't nose? Well played.
I don't nose. Yeah. I didn't even mean to do that.
I do have a little bump on my nose that sometimes I think maybe I'll get fixed, but I don't think so.
Okay, I'm looking at your nose right now, and I don't see it.
Right here.
You have a small nose.
I still don't see it.
Nose.
You don't see the bump?
Nope.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah, see, Todd sees it.
But if you break your nose enough times with like a...
I can't stop looking at it!
Why is it winking
at me?
It's
like waving!
It's so angry!
It's like a blinking light! That's a bump.
So, to make this a little bit on topic...
Okay.
A little bit on topic. Did you know Kevin Spacey's up to something?
Oh.
Absolutely, he's up to something. He's gotta be.
So, I just want to play this for you right here.
Oh, no. What are you doing, Spacey?
This is officially when favorite TV show and reality overlaps.
Oh, no.
I know what you want. Oh, sure, they may have tried to separate us, but what we have is too strong. It's too powerful.
This is a non-character.
And after all, we shared everything, you and I. I told you my deepest, darkest secrets. I showed you exactly what people are capable of. I shocked you with my honesty, but mostly I challenged you and made you think. And you trusted me, even though you knew you shouldn't. So we're not done, no matter what anyone says. And besides, I know what you want. You want me back. Of course, some believed everything and have just been waiting with bated breath to hear me confess it all. They're just dying to have me declare that everything said is true and that I got what I deserved. Wouldn't that be easy if it was all so simple? Only you and I both know it's never that simple, not in politics and not in life. But you wouldn't believe the worst without evidence, would you? You wouldn't rush to judgments without facts, would you? Did you?
Is this a genius move by Kevin Spacey?
You're smarter than that. Anyway, all this presumption made for such an unsatisfying ending. And to think it could have been such a memorable send-off. I mean, if you and I have learned nothing else these past years, it's that in life and art, nothing should be off the table. We weren't afraid, not of what we said, not of what we did, and we're still not afraid. Because I can promise you this.
He's fucking brilliant.
If I didn't pay the price for the things we both know I did do, I'm certainly not going to pay the price for the things I didn't do. Well, of course, they're going to say I'm being disrespectful, not playing by the rules, like I ever played by anyone's rules before. I never did, and you loved it. Anyhow... Despite all the poppycock, the animosity, the headlines, the impeachment without a trial, despite everything, despite even my own death, I feel surprisingly good. And my confidence grows each day that soon enough, you will know the full truth. Well, wait a minute. Now that I think of it, you never actually saw me die, did you?
Okay. So, that is...
His character from House of Cards.
Yes, character in House of Cards. And that is absolutely brilliant because of the shit that's going on in his actual life.
Yeah, but isn't that what he's referring to? He's pretending to be his character, but he's talking about himself.
That is the brilliant thing, because it can be, no, I was talking about the character on the TV show.
Yep.
Yeah, but it's not sanctioned or whatever by Netflix.
Doesn't matter.
So obviously, it's not
him. He didn't say that. He didn't say that was him either.
He didn't.
I absolutely agree with him that he shouldn't be found guilty before a trial and all that stuff.
Well, that's how today is, though.
Yeah, sadly.
No, it is sad, but then again, at the same time, there is a good thing about that as well, because it's making people think twice now before doing the things that they know they shouldn't be doing. So that is the good part that has come out of that. But there is also people who are being burned and being guilty before, you know, before due process.
Well, and that's the problem. We forget that you're innocent until proven guilty rather than guilty before proven innocent.
We have touched on this many times.
It is a very slippery slope.
It is, but I think that is absolutely genius because I believe there's been a new accusation that has come out.
What? Who?
With Kevin Spacey,
yeah. Another one with an even younger kid.
What was it, 18 or 14?
14, I think.
Yeah, something like that, when he was 18.
No, this one was on the set of a movie. A producer's kid or something.
There was another accusation that came out about him. And then this comes out, but it is a... Is it a way to keep him kind of on people's minds of, yes, he was this brilliant actor, or... Wow, well, Spacey, he created another new card that he could drop down and play. Because of Spacey,
it's great he's standing up for himself instead of retreating to the shadows. But I think he also needs to do it in the proper way in the court of law against the actual... Because this one, I believe, has actually brought forward criminal charges.
Spacey.
I don't know. I have to admit, it's completely unfair... What happened to him in a sense of the moment that someone said, hey, this happened, he was just cut right off. There was what's going on here? It was like, nope, we're out, we're out.
Flip side.
And you know what? I want to blame Bill Cosby for this.
Oh, Cosby.
Because how that got dragged through the mud so bad, and how people were like, this is like... I don't mean necessarily negative in terms of the victims. I mean in terms of this was America's TV dad for how many decades?
Yeah, and that shows just how many women had to come forward to actually put a dent in him.
So now the networks I don't trust any situation right now. If they can topple down, I guess, network's TV dad, we don't want to take the risk at all. So we just cut the ties right away and just deal with it.
So on the flip side, though, you have... Let's say Spacey is this monster who has done this to many people.
I don't think he's a monster.
How do we know? He's an actor.
That's true. Like, we don't know.
How do we know that Bill Cosby wasn't this wholesome guy that everyone wanted to have a dad like TV dad Bill Cosby, who was, you know, lessons and happy family and this and that?
Dave Chappelle did a really great bit about that. I don't know if you saw his special on Netflix, but where he talked about, okay, you can have a hero... that saves a lot of lives, but he gains his powers through raping people. Would you put up with that? You have someone saving lives, but he's raping people. Oh. And that was Dave Chappelle's... I'm simplifying it like crazy.
Well, yeah, that's a conundrum.
Crazy. Like, that's how he interprets Bill Cosby, is that he did a lot. He did, but he also has this dark side.
He did a lot, but he did a lot.
He did a lot.
That's a question that I cannot or be prepared to answer.
Why not?
Just because I haven't given it enough thought.
You're not prepared?
Have not given it enough thought. I would honestly say, through the ashes, another hero would arise. So, therefore, I would say, if a hero has his powers and is able to save massive amounts of people, but gets his powers by raping other people, I would say I would not take that hero.
I'd agree there. But that's mostly because...
Wow, this shit's getting way too deep. I was kind of lighten the mood and we could just shit on Kevin Spacey here and your guy's like, nope, we're going pretty fucking dark. Why don't you go ahead and bring up politics while you're at it too?
I love politics.
Go Trump.
I love politics.
No, I'm kidding. Don't
well,
go Trump.
Well, speaking of mushroom dicks.
Oh, that's fair enough. Did you know Donald Duck's head upside down looks like Donald Trump?
I have seen that.
I have it's not seen that.
Fucked up my life.
Oh, I got a new one for you.
Oh.
I got a new one for you. You might have to pause the recording for a second so it can be set up.
Okay, well, we're running out of time, so you're going to have to make it quick.
Okay, pause.
And pause.
Okay, pull up on YouTube. Oh, God. Did Grover drop the F-bomb?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, I heard about that on Sesame Street.
Yes.
Yeah.
Did it actually happen? They just think...
This is the new Yanni
Laurel. Oh, my God. Oh, that's loading. Is there going to be an ad?
There's no such thing as a perfect writer. This is why I use Grammarly to check my...
Thanks, Grammarly. If I'm putting here's my grammar. Fuck off.
Okay, before you play it...
To follow you.
Move the camera! Yes! Yes, that sounds like an excellent idea!
Wait, what did Grover just say?
Move the camera! Yes! Yes, that sounds like an excellent idea!
Sounds
some
like
are asking whether the Sesame Street
that's
character
a fucking excellent
a
idea.
Bad word
that
on
sounds
the children's
like
program.
Okay, hold on.
I do not know what epiphany means, but I believe I have just had one.
After seeing a Reddit user post the short clip from the show. It then sparked a debate brought to you by the letter F, if you know what I mean.
F-Rock is the letter of the day. F-Rock is the letter of the day. F-Rock is the letter.
It's not even Sesame Street. I thought it was Sesame Corner now or something.
It's now being compared to the so Laurel Yanny audio.
No, no.
I don't know.
No, there's probably a YouTube one that will just loop it a few times.
Oh, God. Okay, well, we can do something similar to this, and we'll wrap it up on this a little. It's all about tricking the mind and believing something.
Exactly.
You know that I am called the Count.
Yes, I love this one.
These kids forgot about this.
Because I really...
Do one thing, you can change...
Oh.
You changed the entire
sometimes
song.
Sometimes I sit and all day.
Good old bleeps.
Sometimes
on that note, that's it, Dan. Go ahead and wrap it up.
Right, am I going to talk about the...
I slowly, slowly,
no, Dan.
Slowly getting faster. Once I
say it, Dan.
It's very hard right. To stop.
Bye-bye.
Faster, faster. It is so exciting. I could... Forever, until I drop. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. I love whatever the amount. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, yeah, 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 hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. That's the song of the count. I f*** the spiders on the wall. I f*** the cobwebs in the hall.